So, those are face. It's almost impossible to influence politics through the vote. But if you have sufficient tension within society developed such that an explosion of discontent emerges within the society.
And I was talking to this Muslim stall, and a community policewoman comes up to me and says, can you quiet down a bit? And it looks bad on CCTV. They're watching a crowd form, and they're worried because a crowd is forming and listening to somebody having a conversation, you see? And that
it's so subversive.
The place for that is Speaker's Corner. Yeah. Where you got so much rubbish being talked, and it's for the tourists, you see. So the thing is makes you, you've got to be more clever than what they are, and you've got to use the internet to your advantage and try and get reliable sites on the internet.
You must be born again. Being born again means God transforming your heart, accepting Jesus.
The baby is a sinner.
She's going to sign on her own the day of judgment. Everybody is going to sign on his own and give yourself account to God. So for you to say, I'm a Muslim, a Christian, a Buddhist, a foolishness for God. Eh? The message is forgiveness.
Why is it in Nigeria you have a bunch of Muslims? They kidnapped 200 school children. And you Muslims in Speaker's Corner don't say a word about it.
Why did you
you want to go to Syria?
Well, here we are, Speaker's Corner London. Welcome to it. It's a lovely May Sunday, usually warm.
May Sunday. Go on, try.
I'm trying to see, Finn, I've got to try and hear my own thoughts so
all
I can
right.
say something, you know?
Right.
We'll start again, all right?
Start again.
I always like to welcome people here. And it's actually quite lively, partly because it's such a nice warm day. But it's interesting that in about 5 days' time, next Thursday, 22nd May, there's going to be some elections. And I do vote. The fellow holding the camcorder, Finn, doesn't vote, and that's fine. But I believe that by taking part in this nonsense, it gives me a right to criticise it and so forth. What I want to say, which is surprising to me myself, is that I'm dropping my long-term support for the Liberal Democrats. My leader of that party at the moment is Nick Clegg. May not be for very much longer. And I'm switching my allegiance to UKIP, which means United Kingdom Independence Party. UKIP, I'm wide awake. Now, I'm going to start, though, strange enough, by saying what I don't like about UKIP. What I don't like about UKIP, nothing to do with racism or nationalism or all this petty rubbish in the media. Now, what I don't like about UKIP is their Zionism. Their support for the Zionist entity, the State of Israel. They have a craven support for the State of Israel, which has engaged a long-term project of ethnic cleansing. But the trouble is, there's no real choice. I mean, Sir Nigel Farage, KG, meaning Kingdom of God, Sir Nigel Farage complains rightly about the three main parties, how there's no choice. And that's true. For example, you could try nuclear submarines, which one of you vote Labour, Conservative, or Lib Dem? I voted Lib Dem. You get the European Union, whether you vote Labour, Conservative or Lib Dem. So there's no real choice, ladies and gentlemen. The EU, which means the European Union, started off what I did vote for as a young idealistic student was the EEC, the European Economic Community. But it turns out the federal superstate, this fascist bureaucratic monstrosity, was always in the works. And they just kind of, it's a drip, drip, drip effect. They just steadily take us in. A bit like when you put the frog in the pan of water. You don't put it in the boiler, you slowly take the water up to boil. The frog doesn't know it's been cooked. Of course, I don't recommend anybody harm a frog or any other creature of God. But the analogy stands. So there's no real choice between the Lib Dems, because they're pro-Israel, pro-Zionist. New Labour, they're pro-Israel, pro-Zionist. The Conservatives, they're pro-Israel, pro-Zionist. Further to the right than UKIP, the BNP, incredibly, sure enough, they're also pro-Israel, pro-Zionist. I think you might have to go to the far left to something like the Socialist Workers' Party to get any outfit that actually cares about the plight of the Palestinian people who've been brutalised all these decades. However, the only party which is advocating getting out of this bureaucratic monster is UKIP. So, with a slight reluctance, I'm going to vote UKIP. I intend to vote UKIP on Thursday, and Thursday can't come quick enough. And I find that as many people feel the same way. But I'd be interested to see the outcome, because I consider that our elections might be rigged, just like other people's elections are rigged. Why not ours? You know, with so many scandals unfolding, and hopefully more to come. I mean, who knew but Rolf Harris? I mean, good God, you know, that fellow he's didgeridoo. And Sir Jimmy Savile, and what do they both in common? Oh yeah, they're both mates of the Queen and the Royal Gang. It's alleged that this paedophile ring is right into the Royal Family. You could well believe it, and I wouldn't be at all surprised. We've got to root out this sickness out of a country, out of a society. Because children are literally the future, and their well-being should be paramount for everybody. I shouldn't even need to say that, it's so obvious. But of course, children everywhere is used. Some are used as weapons and terrorist outrages. Children are abused in all kinds of ways. The so-called Boko Haram, which isn't a real name, but Haram means forbidden. Apparently they don't like the education, Western education, and so forth. It's a lot worse than Western education could affect Nigeria and other parts of Africa. The US is worried about China making inroads there. So it turns out that Boko Haram are financed from this country, from the UK and from Saudi Arabia. And suddenly when it suits it, these people, guess what, there's an outrage and all these girls are kidnapped. I thought that would be it's a wonderful idea, Finn, you know, kidnap the kids and then get the glorious heroes of the Special Air Service, the SAS, who've been besmirched because one of their members let it out that that regiment that were involved in the murder of Diana, Princess of Wales, the night of August 30th into August 31st, 1997. So here's a great way for SAS, for the SAS, to redeem themselves and be the glamorous heroes and saviours. But in fact, Christians have been getting massacred and killed there for months, maybe even years, and no one gives a shit. I mean, I'm not a Christian, but it's interesting that none of these people speak out. Maybe because the politicians are so busy licking the asshole of Netanyahu that they can't actually be concerned about Christians in Africa or indeed anywhere else. This is not a Christian country, you know what I mean? That should be obvious to anybody looking at it. And any born again here would probably do it. Ladies and gentlemen, we're not world leaders, we're not heads of corporations, we're not famous people. Maybe Danny Shineover, that's Danny back. He's the best known figure thanks to the internet. But sometimes you have to believe in yourself, and you have to kind of show yourself up. You have to, in some way, make yourself feel better about yourself. There's no point looking at the movie stars and the rock stars and thinking, I wish I was one of them. They're there, and you're you. So, a few years ago now, I appointed myself visiting professor of conspiracy theory at Speaker's Corner, London. And as a long time student of conspiracy theory, it seemed obvious to me that Sir Nigel Farage has had a smear campaign organised against him, probably by MI5 or some similar shady outfit. Because these kind of revelations and these stories, one guy's apparently got tattoos of an eagle in his arm, and that apparently makes him somehow align with Nazism, because he's got an eagle tattooed on his arm. And the idea is to equate the UKIP with Nazism, which is hilarious, because the thing that UKIP opposes, the European Union, is inherently fascist. And we need to get out of this monstrosity as soon as possible. A couple of weeks ago on Question Time, the one Green MP at the moment, Carlin Lucas, read out, apparently on the train on the way to the TV studio where they recorded the programme, she had made a list of all the benefits and all the great things that we got from the European Union. But I heard the list, she read it out, of course, rapidly, but all the list that Carlin read, there's nothing on there that we could not have instituted for ourselves as a remarkable island people. And we have always been a multicultural society. Britain is an ancient multicultural society, and what made Britain great was the mix of all the peoples that came here. People from Friends Island, people from Scandinavia, from Germany, from Denmark, from France, the Romans of course. A rich multicultural society, and we've got all that rich mix again, and who knows what wonderful things it could produce. We can do these things for ourselves. We don't need to be part of this federal, totalitarian, unelected bureaucracy. So I'm very suspicious, ladies and gentlemen, as a long-time student of conspiracy theory. No one's actually said it, but I think the intelligence services have probably got together a few goons. They've told them to. So someone comes out, someone joins UKIP as a counsellor, goes through the motions, looks plausible, and then they get the phone call, and then they come out with the black people are monkeys, and then the media then splash that everywhere. How is it that the so-called right-wing Daily Mail has been attacking the so-called right-wing UKIP on an almost daily basis? Of course, it's not just the Daily Mail on the right that's attacking UKIP. You've got the Guardian on the left attacking. But this left-right paradigm, those of us at Speaker's Corner, people like Nicholas and myself, we've seen through that long ago. There is no left and right paradigm, it's just a scam. Both sides are controlled by the same hidden force. And indeed, the real architects of the European Union are largely unknown. The directives there and the moves towards this federalism, and there's Nick Clegg on the radio saying, well, don't worry about the word federalism, which is in the Treaty of Rome. You know, it's just a word. No, it isn't. I mean, the idea is to have a kind of United States of Europe. I mean, but we are very different. We have a very different history from the United States of America. Do we actually want to have, for example, a Second Amendment where everybody can walk about with guns like they have in the USA? I hope not. I mean, the US is largely, if you don't count the Native American languages, you know, it's like Cheyenne and so forth, the US is primarily English and Spanish. The Europe's having, you know, all sorts of tongues here. I mean, and we are, apart from Europe, like Ireland, we're the British Isles, and we're separate from the Europe, the Channel Tunnel notwithstanding. And we need to believe in ourselves and see what the future holds. And let's make our own future, not direct through directives coming from Brussels or Strasbourg or anywhere else, but coming from our own hearts and with a conviction of what's right. And he is risky voting for Nigel Farage because some of the guys around him are slightly dodgy, but let's try something different. Thank you for listening. God bless you.
But my intuition telling me that I should talk to you, you know, I'm going by my intuition.
You said earlier I didn't understand you completely.
I would like to understand you completely.
I don't even understand me completely.